Hello everyone, I'm Chan from Talent Battle. I welcome you all to our new video. In this video, we are going to check the previous year's TCS Digital verbal section questions or English section questions. As we know, TCS Digital is planning to hire 2022 batch students. This video will help you to prepare for it. Also, you can join our training for TCS Digital, in which we'll cover English, quants, advanced coding questions along with all previous year questions. Also, join our social media handles like Telegram group, Instagram page, and WhatsApp group. We constantly update placement preparation updates and off-campus updates on our pages. Links to all these handles are given in the description below. So before we start, do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon for instant notifications about our videos. So without any further ado, we'll just start with the previous year questions. Okay, let us try to answer this question. If you observe, this question is from Parajumbles. So what you can do is you can just pause the screen and try to answer on your own for every question. Once you thought of an answer, resume and check with the explanation part. Now let us try to answer this question. So we have to arrange A, B, C, D in a meaningful order, and the options are given below. If you observe options, every option is starting with a different sentence. So first, let us try to eliminate at least one. If you observe very properly, here if you observe, there is a sentence starting with these, that is D. Now, given they have sentence of paragraph, right? That means this also must be the starting of the paragraph. So tell me, can any paragraph or passage, can it start with these people? No, these people are which people? So there should be something before this point called this. So I can easily eliminate option D. I hope you have understood why we have eliminated option D, because it is starting with these people. And we don't know which people they are talking about, right? So I can easily eliminate option B. Okay, let us try to find the link in between these two only. Now, there are a few strategies where you have to apply for Parajumbles. So let me tell you what actually help you here. Here, we have a strategy called noun-pronoun strategy. Tell me everybody, what is these people? These people, I can say, this is a pronoun. These people is nothing but a pronoun. So this pronoun should talk about a noun. Why? Because noun comes first, then only pronoun comes next. So here also, we should have a noun before these people. So tell me everybody, these people, that means it must be containing a plural people, as in more number of people, right? You tell me sentence ABC, which is containing the term called people, or which talks about some people. If you observe here, India has over 9 million textile crafts people with skills unmatched by any other country. And then comes D. These people also have an enormous repertoire. Which people? These people in India. So definitely there is a link in between B and D. So B, D must then should be next to each other. Why? Because D is talking about these people, right? And B is talking about the craftsmen. That is nothing but the people they have. So definitely B, D must be a pair. Now you tell me which of the option is containing B, D. Exactly. Only option C is containing BD. So that's what my answer must be. Now, if you observe, somebody can tell me, sir, they is also here. They also can talk about the word called people. But if you observed yours here, the skills to make India a global handloom hub exist. Yes, the skills exist, but they are dying for lack of proper infrastructure and planning. What are dying? The skills are dying, dears. So here they refers to what? To skills, not people. The only term that refers these people is nothing but the craftsmen, right? So that must be my answer. Option C is my answer. So here, what is the strategy we applied, everybody? That is noun pronoun strategy. Like, we have many strategies, like noun pronoun is one of them. And next is chronological order. What means chronological order? There'll be some numbers which are in particular order, 1870, 1875, and then comes 1890, etc., etc. That is nothing but a chronological order, right? And then I can say start and the conclusion, right? Now, when it comes to starting, long, long ago, there used to be a king. Now, not exactly like long, long ago, it can define the starting of the paragraph. Similarly, conclusion, henceforth, therefore, finally. These are some terms which talk about the conclusion. That is one of the strategies. And also one more strategy we can say is idea and elaboration. Idea and elaboration, where they'll give us an idea in the paragraph or the passage, and then they elaborate it, right? So first they can talk about only one particular object. For example, human beings. This is the idea of the paragraph. And then talk about the elaboration part, right? How human beings evolve and how they are performing in this current generation, etc., etc. I hope you got it. So there are some strategies which helps you in answering the para-Gimbel's questions, right? So you need to focus on the other strategies also. So moving on to the next one, let us check this question out. Select the option that is most appropriate for the blank. So we need to just fill the blank using one of these four options we have. Let us read the sentence. He dash helped us if he really wanted to. Looking at the options, could, should have, should, could have. Guys, here we can easily eliminate two options. What are they? If you understand the statement properly. Yes. Given statement is, if he really wanted to. What is really wanted to? If he wanted, that means if he is willing to help or if he is capable to help. Correct? So here given should have and should. What is should? Should is compulsion. Should is nothing but a compulsion. Where will is talking about the willingness. Similarly, could or can. Is talking about the capability. So people tell me, should he must definitely help them? No, it's up to him. If he is willing to or if he is capable, he would have helped us. Right? So I can eliminate two options. What are they? Option B, option C are gone. Why? Because C and B talks about the compulsion. Right? They talk about the compulsion. Now, coming up to the other options in between A and D. In between A and D, that is could, comma, could have. Let me tell you what could be the correct one, which we can take it as an answer. Okay? If you observe, here we have two statements. One is a main clause, the other is a if clause. Main clause is he dash helped us. If clause is starting with if. Okay. As we have two events or two statements, I can say. And one is an if clause. Remember, whenever there is an if clause and when it is in simple past, when it is in simple past, the main clause must contain the word called have. Always remember this. Here, if you observe, if we really wanted, it's just simple. It is not any past continuous, past perfect, etc. It is just simple past. If we really wanted to, right? As it is simple past, the main clause should contain what? Should contain have. So definitely my answer should be what? Could have, but not could. Look, he could helped us. When we read itself, we will sense that this is wrong. He could helped us. That is nowhere meaningful, right? He could have helped us. Is the correct sentence that I can say. And why? That is because of a rule called the two events rule. Whenever we have if clause in simple past, the main clause must contain have. So this is the answer for the second question, that is option D. Okay, checking this question. You have a passage over here where there are some blanks you have to fill with the given options. Now let us check with the question. The artist cannot merely dash an ideal. So let us check where actually this statement is. In the passage, it is over here. Yeah. The artist cannot merely dash an ideal. Fine. Try to read ahead of this sentence. Let us read from here. Good art must connect with ordinary lives. It must be relatable. It must connect with themes that other people's lives are influenced by. Full stop. The artist cannot merely just an ideal. Fine. I got an idea what they're actually talking about. They're actually talking about some art and how the art must be. The art must connect with their ordinary lives and it must be relatable. And also must be connecting with the themes that other people's lives are getting influenced by. And then they are saying the artist cannot merely dash an ideal. What actually this merely means? Merely. It means just. Just. Right? The artist cannot just dash an ideal. Fine. Let us look at the options now. The artist just cannot create an ideal. Fine. We can just keep a hold on this. The artist cannot merely correct an ideal. No, no meaning for this. Now, whatever the art they are making, the art must be very influencing, right? The art must be very influencing. So that is why we can say the artist cannot just create an ideal. Okay, it must have something speciality, right? Now, talk about the next option. Option C, abjure. What means abjure? Look, it is all about vocabulary. Yes, you should be very good at vocabulary when you are answering some blanks or anonyms or synonyms, etc. Now, abjure, when we don't know something, what we'll do? We'll try to Google. When you Google it, you'll get the meaning. That's fine, right? And then you try to answer somehow. But the point is not just learning, dears. It's all about application. Because only when you apply in reality, then only you remember for a longer time. It is just like a song, okay? Now, whenever you do sing some songs for so many times, you basically register that in your brains, right? Similarly, here also you need to just remember the words for so long a time. And how it can be done? It can be done with the application or utilization. So you have to speak, you have to use for so many times, right? Yeah, basically we are human. So we are humans, we forget things. I can accept that. But still we have to do some efforts to remember. Now here, abjure. What actually abjure? If you just Google it, you'll get it as rigid. But my point is how to remember this for a long time. Now, if you observed yours, if you just read it from the last, reject, that's just the sound like reject. It is like a mnemonic. Okay, it is just like a mnemonic. What is a mnemonic? It is just mimicking deers. It is just like a mimicry of a word. So here you mimic the word called abjure as a reject, These are remember for a longer time, right? So I cannot say the artist cannot just reject an ideal. There is no point of rejection at all. Now, adore. I know there are many people who knows this word, okay, adore. But there are few who might not know the meaning of this word. For example, dear, adore, if you Google it, you'll get it as a admire, right? And one more word, I'll tell you what is that one more word, in which way you can remember. Look, admire, that is one simple word. And the other word is, just try to retell here, how this word is looking like. It's looking like love, exactly. The other synonym for adore is love, admire or love. So this is how you can remember for longer time years. I hope this strategy is helping you, okay? To remember the words or unknown words or new words for longer time. So love. Okay, here the artist cannot just love an ideal. Yeah, it is. He just cannot love an ideal, but still there must be something, right? So the artist cannot just create an ideal, but he should do something to influence people's lives. That is what exactly the option can fit. Option A will be the meaningful order for this. Others I can eliminate or I cannot consider them. I hope you understood. Now I'll tell you one more word, okay? I'll tell you one more word. Can I? Funny word? Let me do it. Now, for example, how many of you know the meaning of this word? Satanic. Okay, might few of you know, might not, right? Everyone knows. But let me check how easily it can be done. When you observe the meaning of this word called satanic, it gives you evil or devil. Googling. After Googling, you have to make sure that you are remembering this word for a longer time. How? One is usage. Use for so many times so that you remember. Or second is mnemonics. What is mnemonics? If you observe the here, there is a word called Satan. In Hindi, Telugu, Tamil or other regional language, if I'm not wrong, there is a word called Saitan. Right? Saitan. What is Saitan? Saitan is nothing but devil. Right? So simply we can remember this way. Right? If you doesn't know, you can just know that. Satan is nothing but Saitan, which is like a evil or devil. This is how you can remember these words. But not every time you can do this. Wherever it is applicable, we'll apply that. I hope you like the strategy. Now, moving on to the next. Select the option that is the meaning of an underlined word or segment in a given context. Please allow me to pick your brain on this topic. Fine. To pick your brain doesn't mean you have to pick off someone's brain or you have to take off someone's brain. Let us check the options first. To find fault in you, to talk to an intelligent person such as you, to irritate you, to obtain more information from. Can eliminate one or more options? Yeah, we can do it. Why? Because it simply says, please allow me to dash on this topic. I can say to discuss on this topic or to talk on this topic, etc., etc. But can I say to find fault in you on this topic? No, not much. And again, to irritate you? Now, will someone ask, please allow me to irritate you on this topic? Nobody, right? They just ask you because they want some information, right? In between B and D, you tell me which could be the best one. Why? Because they say meaningful, right? Meaningful of the underline. Now you tell me what could be. If you observe here, look what he wanted just to interact so that he can get some more information. Whenever we say to pick your brain, it doesn't mean the other person must be intelligent. It just means they need more information from you, whether it may be right or wrong. I hope you understand my point, yes. Please allow me to obtain more information from you. Whether it is right or wrong, that doesn't matter. They just need some information from you, some more information from you. And when we say more, it actually means that means the other person might know better than the person who is asking the question. That I can say. But not always intelligent. Right? So I hope you understood this point. So the answer must be option D. Right? Not intelligent for sure. Maybe may not be. But definitely he requires more information. So that's what the objective is. Moving on to the next one. She kept looking at the men behind the counter in utter disbelief. She had thought that the Thanjavu painting would dash, dash as gems were not precious. Fine. First of all, let us look at the options. Cause an arm and a hand. Who would say an arm and a hand? No, not the words which can be used one to other. Arm and a leg? Yes. An arm and a leg? Yes. two arms and two legs are fine, maybe, but let us check the other part. But it was dirt cheap. What is this dirt cheap? Look, whenever we say cheap, whenever something is very, very cheap, what do we use the word? We use an adjective called dead cheap. Dead cheap is a correct word with cheap, correct? But can we say dirt? What means dirt, first of all? Dirt is dust, right? Look, dead means not a non-living thing, etc., etc. We generally use it as a dirt cheap. It is just a usage. So here, dust cheap we don't say, or dirt cheap is not a correct term which we can use with cheap. So I can eliminate what options? A can eliminate, C can eliminate, D can eliminate. So the only option that is left is cost an arm and a leg, comma, it was dead cheap. Now let us look at the sentence. What she thought? She thought, she had thought the Thanjavur painting would cost an arm and a leg. What means this cost an arm and a leg? Whenever we say it cost me an arm and a leg, it means it is so expensive. We generally say it cost my kidney to get an iPhone, right? In memes, when you hear, right? It is just the same. It cost me an arm and a leg means it is so expensive to buy. So she thought that Thanjavur painting would cost an arm and a leg, but it was dead cheap. Why it was dead cheap? As the gems were not precious. Because the gems were not precious, it was dead cheap. I hope you understood the point. So the only option that satisfies is option B. So everybody, that's all we have for this video. And I thank you for watching the video till the end. If you have liked the video, do not forget to press the like button and also please share it to your friends where they'll also get benefit. Also join our social media handles like Telegram group, Instagram page and WhatsApp. Links to all this are given in the description below. And do not forget to subscribe to get more updates. Thank you all.